Yeah. That's an old automobile there. Yeah, right there. I think that's a C5 Galaxy there, Steve. Oh, yeah. Oh, B29 Straddle Fortress. Here's a helicopter. Some guys call it the banana helicopter.
So were you guys able to bring the B17?
Unfortunately, we were not.
Yeah, the B29.
But she said we can go in and come out.
Yeah. Yeah, so we'll do. I walk all the way around it, all the way over to the tail gunner. And you imagine what that's like? The massive wheels here.
Turn around. How was your mom? Smile behind your mask.
I'm over on the other side, Steve. Okay, it's Renegade Biker 24. And where we're at is at Drake Field in Fayetteville. And this is one of the, this is one of the planes, the B29. And we call it Strato Fortress. And this is what we have. B29 Superfortress. I call it Strato Fortress, but yeah, it's a super fortress. As you can tell, that sucker's massive. But I don't think they're going to be giving any more rides today. Said their last ride's at 5, so this is the end of the line here. So. But anyway, as you can tell here, this is, I think, the ones used in World War II as part of the bombing of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. So, but anyway. You can tell here, this is the hills of Northwest Arkansas. So,
all that is.
But it was on the forestall, and what he did was wet start. He's otherwise known as wet start.
What's that mean?
Johnny Wet Start. Basically,
that's how they refueled with that little coal crunch.
Yeah, because Navy planes now, they come out. Well, Navy planes, what they'll do is, there's like a fueling probe on the front part.
Out in front and up?
Well, actually, for the F-4 or the F-14, it would come out the side, and that's how it would work. Okay. Yeah, it looks like a B-25 Mitchell. Well, the small one there, yeah. That one kind of looks like a B-25.
Yeah,
Yeah, I got this from Amazon.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. No, I don't have it on the way. That'd be Instagram, and to me, I'm confused about Instagram when it comes to recording live. Looks like he's following the same pattern.
Yeah, it's a field pattern.
Yeah.
Unless he's gonna do a low flight line there.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Like I say, I've seen a B29 come off.
That's pretty good.
But you can imagine the Japanese would see this coming. I don't know what altitude they were at when they dropped the bomb.
Yeah.
But you get it out there, that just looks like a speck out there.
Mm-hmm.
And then all of a sudden,
if you get in here, watch your head. I'll tell you that right now. It's just a little cramped. Huey Cobra. Two flying ace. There's another, looks like flying banana. There's a trainer. This is a P-51 Mustang. Flying banana. Paiseki H21 workhorse. And then there's a flying right there. There's the old Huey. Medevac or dust off. And the Huey right here. There's a tow missile system. Like a final? They're probably gonna go to the end of the runway, come back.
university flying club.
No.
They said now they're offering like aeronautics. So you take your regular courses and this is another course.
Oh, okay.
And I think you end up getting your pilot's license. It's part of fairly expensive.
Yeah, it looks like he's got two of the inboard and the two outboard.
Yeah. It really is.